I'm tired of having it personally, because every time I get it, I can't wear all black. That's my favorite thing to wear. I get a little pile on my shoulder. I can't see it. People are like, oh, is that dandruff on your shoulder? No, that's part of the shirt. I have to act like it's supposed to be there. What's going on, everybody? I'm JC Mendoza. I'm your host. This is Uncomfortable Questions. With me today, as always, is the knowledgeable Dr. Knox Beasley. He is a board-certified dermatologist and a hair loss specialist. And I'm so glad you're here, Dr. Knox, because more than anything, when I got this opportunity to be able to talk to somebody so knowledgeable out here about hair, the first thing that came to my mind is the thing that I suffer with the most. I have some of the most aggressive dandruff that I feel like anybody has ever seen. If my dandruff were to be here right now, they would have to like bleep it out because it's so aggressive. It's just so rude. And I always thought that dandruff was, and I'm going to let you talk at some point. What is dandruff?
Sure. So this is going to be great for you. So
yeah.
Dandruff is a common term we use to describe an itchy, flaky scalp.
Okay.
This is super common. I see it every single day. A lot of times there's the medical diagnosis we use is what's called seborrheic dermatitis. That's kind of the medical, like the medical jargon for a lot of dandruff. What's going on is you have the flaking and the itching and a lot of inflammation in the scalp. I'm not exactly 100% sure what the exact cause is, and that's why we can't cure it.
Got you. So usually if it's an itchy, flaky scalp, is every time it's an itchy, flaky scalp, is that dandruff every time you experience that?
Yeah, great question. So no. Okay. There's certainly things like dandruff or the seborrheic dermatitis are a very, very common cause, but there can be other things. So there can be other conditions that can look like it, like a psoriasis could look like it as well. Or if, you know, it's an irritant, like let's say you have male pattern hair loss and you decide, oh, I'm going to start some minoxidil. That can be drying or can be irritating the scalp, which can cause a flaky scalp. So no, you don't have dandruff, but you just have that irritation, which is causing that flaking and that's what's contributing, but it can look like it.
I feel like a big reason why like myself and people may get so like active around the word dandruff is it's so commonly associated with hair loss. Is there any link between dandruff and hair loss?
So dandruff itself isn't causing hair loss.
Okay.
But if you've got this itchy scalp that you're just scratching constantly, you're causing a lot of inflammation and inflammation is not what you want on your hair. You know, that's gonna contribute to hair loss. So it's not that it directly causes it, but there could be a little bit of a link just between the itching and scratching.
Okay, so dandruff, like less of a hair loss effect and just more of like a itchy, dry, flaky scalp, like you said. So are there any ways that you can treat dandruff?
There's a lot of treatments that can work and can be effective. So there's medicated shampoos. There's over-the-counter shampoos that can work too, whether it has zinc or ketoconazole, selenium sulfide. There's different ones out there that have a lot of evidence behind them. There's prescription shampoos. There's topicals that we can use, sometimes even pills that you can use to get these in severe cases to get it under control.
And what would the first thing that you would, not prescribe somebody, but the first advice as a dermatologist that you would give somebody who comes in with a concern about dandruff in their situation?
First thing we're going to do is take a look and make sure it's just dandruff, you know, not a condition like psoriasis or something else that could be mimicking a dandruff. But once we decide, yep, this is just dandruff or seborrheic dermatitis, then we're going to go into the different options, pros and cons of each. That way you can make an informed medical decision, you know, of what you want to do and where you want to start.
Right. And is there I forget the medical term for dandruff, something, momatitis, what was that?
Seborrheic dermatitis.
Seborrheic dermatitis. I don't like how fast you said it, and I'm going to take that as a microaggression. Is there a way to definitively cure?
I did it on purpose.
Yeah, I felt it. I felt it. And anytime I don't finish a sentence, it's your turn to say the thing, because I already care.
Yeah, so there's no cure. There's no cure for seborrheic dermatitis, or sebderm, if you want to put it, you know, shorten it.
You could have led with that.
Yeah, right? I just wanted to see you struggle for a little. There's no cure, but it can be effectively managed for sure.
Okay, that's good to know. And I'm happy that I feel a lot better about the topic. And if you guys have any more uncomfortable questions, I'm sure we're going to get to them. If you suffer from dandruff, come back here to Uncomfortable Questions. Go to your dermatologist, call me, bring me with you, because Dr. Knox is not always here, but I do always need help. And I always need you guys to come back, listen to more Uncomfortable Questions, because we're here for you.